And now to the road to recovery and new fallout from images like these. We first showed you these scenes, people packing beaches and bars to enjoy that weather this weekend. Now, some of the people not even trying to distance. And tonight, leaders in several communities are demanding action to spread out the crowds. So let's start on the Upper East Side, where people swarm bars over the weekend, some even sitting inside. This video here raises questions, of course, about social distancing enforcement. You see a man thrown to the ground by officers. News 4's Rana Navini has new information on that confrontation and the push to give bars and restaurants some breathing room.
City leaders are trying to stop this from happening again. Second Avenue on the Upper East Side looked more like a block party Saturday night, with people gathering in large groups, sitting on the sidewalk and drinking outside of bars. At least one restaurant allowed people to sit inside. At one point, NYPD officers tackled and arrested a man who they say was being combative. He was issued a summons for having an open container. The mayor reiterating Monday that individuals and businesses that don't comply with social distancing orders will be held responsible.
For those who haven't gotten the message, then that's where enforcement comes in.
And I am the first one that's going to die if I get the virus.
Sandy and Harold Rabinowitz live on the Upper East Side and say while they wish people would respect the rules, they want restaurants to be able to make a living.
They have families to feed.
This is one of the bars where people gathered over the weekend. It does have markers on the ground to encourage people to keep a safe distance. But as you saw in those videos, not everyone paid attention.
I saw it and I had zero problem with it.
James O'Hanlon owns the Daisy on 2nd Avenue. He plans to reopen for takeout and delivery this weekend. He thinks the city should make it easier for restaurants to serve people safely outdoors.
I feel it's kind of unfair to ask the business owners to control a street that we can't use ourselves.
At a face mask giveaway, Councilmember Ben Kallos told us he's asking the mayor to close certain corridors with a lot of restaurants to help those businesses spread out. It's part of a growing call from other council members to help businesses thrive while keeping people safe.
If we can't get them to stop, the best thing we can do is provide a way for them to do it safely, and that means opening up our sidewalks, our parking spots, and our streets for safe service with social distancing.
On the Upper East Side, Rana Novini, News 4, New York.